Hello, welcome viewers to Elimu TV, whereby we learn and experience. We are going to have our biology form 1 lesson 20 under the topic nutrition in plants and animals and the subtopic the process of photosynthesis, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerard. We are going to look at the process of photosynthesis. As you know, the photosynthesis is the process by which our green plants they make their own food. The process of photosynthesis, the raw materials for photosynthesis are water and carbon 4 oxide. For the process to take place, it requires the presence of light and a chlorophyll. It occurs in the chloroplast. That is the process. It takes place in the chloroplast, whereby we have the chlorophyll, whereby the chlorophyll is the green coloring matter, which it enables it to absorb light energy. Water and carbon 4 oxide undergo several chemical processes in the presence of sunlight to form carbohydrates, and oxygen is given out as a byproduct. We have a diagrammatic representation of the process of photosynthesis, but before that, the process can be summarized as follows. That is, we are going the carbon 4 oxide, which is taken from the atmosphere, it combines with the water, which is absorbed from the soil, to form a glucose and oxygen. Remember that this oxygen is the one that is given out as a byproduct, which is taken in by animals, and the glucose is used by the plant for growth. However, this process is more complex than what is represented above. It involves the chemical reactions that can be that are going in two general stages. These are the light stage and the dark stage. So as you can see from our diagram, we have the process of photosynthesis, whereby the leaves absorb the we have the sun, and the leaves absorb the energy, that is the light energy, in sunlight, and take in carbon dioxide from the air. So you can see from our diagram, they have the carbon dioxide. And now that process goes it goes to the chloroplast, which are the organelles found in the upper epidermis, and you can see water here is being absorbed from underneath the soil. It is taken up through the xylem. We have these are diagrammatic representations of the process of photosynthesis, whereby we have our oxygen molecules combining with hydrogen molecules plus now carbon 4 oxide to give us carbohydrates. In simple terms, this carbohydrates is the energy that is required by the plant for processes like growth. The hydrogen is then combined with carbon dioxide to produce carbohydrates. We have said that there are two stages that are involved in the process of photosynthesis. The first stage we are looking at is the light stage, whereby in this stage, this is the initial stage in the process of photosynthesis. The chlorophyll molecules absorb light energy, which is used to split water molecules into oxygen and hydrogen atoms. This process is called photolysis of water, and photolysis of water. Remember, photolysis means light, and so you, when you ask what about what is photolysis, you'll say that this is a splitting of water molecules to produce hydrogen and oxygen atoms in the process of photosynthesis. And now from there, the hydrogen atoms that are produced by the splitting of water enter the dark stage, while oxygen is released in the atmosphere or used by a plant for processes like respiration. Some of the solar energy absorbed by the chlorophyll molecules is used in the formation of energy rich in ATP, whereby in this case ATP means adenosine triphosphate, which is later used in the dark stage. Remember, you have said there are two stages, and our first stage that you're dealing with at this level is the light stage. Now we get into the second stage, which is the dark stage. The product of photosynthesis from the first stage, which is the light stage, they undergo, they go to the second stage, which is the dark stage, whereby in this stage, light is present, light might be present or not. Another name for the dark stage is the light independent stage. That is to mean this stage does not depend on light to take place. That is why we are saying light in this stage might be present or not. This process involves carbon 4 oxide with hydrogen atoms, which combine to form a simple sugar such as glucose. This process is known as carbon 4 oxide fixation, which involves a series of enzyme-controlled reactions. The energy required for this reaction is provided by the ATP from the light stage reaction. Remember, you have said that the product of ATP, we get ATP from our light stage. So the ATP goes to our dark stage. The intermediate product, which is a simple sugar, undergoes further reactions to form simple sugar such as glucose. Some of the glucose formed is directly utilized by the plant cells, while the rest is converted to starch and stored in the plant. In addition to glucose, fatty acids and amino acids are also formed in the dark stage of photosynthesis. For an activity basing on our lesson, we are going to explain the process of photosynthesis and give its word equation. For further reference, you can refer to KLB Secondary Biology Students Book 1, 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information on this, you can send us an SMS through the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message on our Facebook page, which is Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu_TV_Kenya. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more lessons. Thank you.